If you were raised in the 80s, I have a product that I think that if you're like me and you like nostalgia, you will think is so adorable, so cute, and if you like interesting packaging and product design, I got you covered there too. I am talking about these cute little adorable 3D eyeshadows from Hip Dot, and they're Care Bear. Look at how cute, 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 cute. And the packaging, it's like a little egg that you snap shut. So cute. Let's get into trying these out. There's four colors, and I am just so excited to play with these. You can buy each color, there's four different colors. You can buy them individually for $16, or you can buy all four for $56 on their website. There's no talc or mineral oil in these, and they are cruelty-free. Purple, which is Share Bear. So cute. I mean, and just the detail of these, their little eyes, the little hair on top of their head, the little tail. So cute. And then we have the yellow gold one is a Fun Shine Bear. And you can even see the little sunshine on his tummy. I mean, just look how cute that is. And then they just snap. We have Grumpy Bear, the blue, and you can see there's a cloud with some raindrops on his tummy. And number six, which is the pink one, Cheer Bear. And so cute. This one in shipping, I think the ear got a little smashed, but so cute. These are all made in China, and there is a 12-month shelf life on each of these. Of the boxes are the colors, you know, correspond with whichever color you're ordering. Have you ever tried any 3D makeup products? It's just so weird. Okay, I'm gonna try it with a brush first. So I'm just gonna go in on the side of her head. I have no idea how much product this will pick up. If you are new to my channel, hello, my name is Stacy. This is Stacy Lee Beauty. I put out multiple videos a week. I am in my mid-40s and I love all things beauty. Fashion, skincare, makeup, it all makes me feel good and happy. It's my happy place. So if you enjoy all things beauty too, I hope that you will consider hitting that subscribe button and sticking around. Now let's get back to trying on these products. And Hip Dot's philosophy is all about rewriting the beauty rules and to say that there are no rules. Okay, so on this brush, not really picking up the product, at least this color. Okay, I'm just gonna take my finger and kind of go on the side of her head as well. So I'm thinking the pink is gonna be more of like a topper, it looks like. I mean, I am getting some pink color if you compare this eye to that one, but it's not gonna be like a bam in your face pink. They do ship the US and many countries out of the US. There is a whole list you can look on their website if you want more information. I will have that link down below. And thank you so much to Hip Dot. They did send these to me complimentary to try out, but there was no requirements of like what to post or what to do. Okay, so you can build this up, it's looking like. There's no scent. Described as a bubblegum pink with a metallic shimmer finish. Okay, let's do a Grumpy Bear. This is described as an electric moody blue with also a metallic shimmer finish. So we're just gonna play around with them and see what it looks like. Normally, I would always do a matte color, but we're just playing it today. And Grumpy is one of the original bears that was in the television series. Did you watch the TV series? What was your favorite, you know, like characters, shows that you watched growing up? I loved, well, Care Bears and Rainbow Bright, Strawberry Shortcake. I don't know if they had shows, but the characters and the Smurfs. I might be forgetting something, but that's what comes to mind. Oh, and My Little Pony. This is a little bit more of a dense brush, so let's see what that does. Now, this one, I'm getting more color on the brush. So these are a creamy baked powder, is how they are described. I mean, look at that blue on the brush. So that one is more pigmented than the pink. Well, and I'm using a more dense brush. So let's just see if I used my finger, what we would get with that. They feel really creamy, and I wasn't sure what to expect. I mean, it's like moving it a little bit, but I'm sure if you kept going in and in, probably the heat from your fingers is going to eventually, you know, kind of melt it down. But on first, you know, just a little bit going in, it's not, as long as you don't push really hard, it's not changing the shape of it. So it's a little bit more pigmented on this one with my finger, but not a huge amount. I feel like it's just making it a little bit more opaque. It's just so stinking cute. What's your thoughts on like cutesy makeup? I'm a sucker. I feel like I'm just, you know, I'm in my 40s, but I guess I'll always have a little bit of a little girl, you know, in me because I just love this kind of stuff. And how Care Bears came about is they were first used on greeting cards for American Greetings. And that was in 1981. Elena is who originally painted them for the greeting cards. In 1983, they had been turned into the plushy stuffed animal characters. And then from 1985 to 1988 is when the television series ran. Okay, let's see how this blends out. Okay, so I really wouldn't recommend, you know, taking a fluffy brush and blending it out like that, unless you just want to get that wash of color, just a little bit of the color, because as you can see, it's kind of, like I still have some blue tint to me, but it's more of a tint now than how it was the color. And then we have the purple one is Share Bear. And when the franchise first came onto the scene, there was only 10 Care Bears. The original bears were, okay, I have an awful memory, so I'm going to have to look at my notes. Bedtime Bear, Birthday, Cheer Bear, so the pink one, Friend Bear, Sunshine Bear, so the yellow, Good Luck Bear, Grumpy, Love A Lot, Tender Heart, and Wish Bear. Those were the original members of the Care Bear cast. So this is a LaRouche brush, and it's even more of a flat shader brush. And this is what we're going to try with the purple one. So we're getting some color payoff there. I'm kind of curious if I wet the brush, what happens? How is everyone doing? How's your October going? I can't believe it's almost the end of October. I'm definitely getting more pigmentation if you wet the brush. Let's go back to, I'm going to wet the brush of the blue one. Yeah, so if you want the most pigmentation, I would say wet the brush. And if you just want a little bit, then use the fluffier brush you use, and the more you like blend them out, the like more of a wash that you're gonna get than pigmentation. We're gonna take, this is a e.l.f. angled eyeliner brush. We're gonna go in, try the yellow with just a dry brush and see. Oh, now look at that one. All right. Okay, that one, is it the brush or is it the color? So far, that is the most pigmented. Now I've got to clean off this brush and see, is it the brush? If you had a dream collab that you could make happen, number one, what brand would it be? Okay, that's a little bit. No, I think it's that color. Ooh, the gold has definitely got some color. Okay, let me finish my other eye, but I am curious. What brand would it be by? And what would the collab be? Would it be a TV show or a character, food, a celebrity? What would be your dreams? Tell me all your dreams. Okay, I'm gonna try that little brush with the blue and see, because I know I already said this, but I'm really curious. They're all supposed to be made the same. Oh, yes. Okay. So you could definitely use this as an eyeliner. For sure, 100%. So if you, the smaller, which makes sense, the smaller, the more dense brush, the more color you're going to get. Let me clean this off and let me show you the purple. I just can't believe how cute these are. It does add a little bit for the purple, but not as much. Let's see what the pink. I am cleaning off the brush in between each use, just FYI. No. All right. So, I mean, it's a little bit better, but this is my thoughts. For the pink, I'd say it's more of just to get that wash of color. The blue, that one, you can do a wash of color, or to get the most pigmentation, I'd use a very dense, small brush. That's gonna give you the best. Purple, it seems like with your finger or wetting the brush is gonna give you the most color. And for that gold, well, oh yeah, I'm gonna need to try the gold with a bigger brush to see, because I mean, that is just, ooh. There is no fallout. Yeah, with your finger, I feel like you're gonna get the most payoff. So it's interesting, the color difference, right? That's what I thought. So if you just want a little bit of the gold, use a fluffy brush. So very interesting. Each color, I'd say, has its own way of how to apply it for the most payoff. You really can't even tell. I mean, okay, so here's the gold. You can see a little bit of his cheek has gone down compared to the other side. I was worried that after, you know, maybe one or two uses, that it would be like all melty and stuff, but it doesn't appear that that's gonna happen. So I've had these on about a couple hours, and I will say I did not put a primer on. I just put a concealer, kind of just to even out my skin tone. They do recommend doing a primer, but whenever I'm trying a new eyeshadow, I like to do it without a primer just to see. I probably should have put one primer on one eye now that I think about it, next time. And I will keep using these and try them with a primer in different color, you know, combinations. But I will say, without a primer at least, it doesn't appear that they're going to be long wearing, just as an FYI, because I don't normally have typically like oily lids. If anything, I'm kind of dry skin, but it does look like it's kind of starting, they're starting to wear a little bit already. It's not creasing so much. I mean, a little bit over here, but the gold, you know, it's kind of still strong. And I'm getting more, it's more of like tints right now, more than as pigmented as it was when I put it on. So just FYI, it might not be the most long wearing shadows, but I will keep you updated. The more I wear them, the more I use them. So if you don't want to miss any updates, then make sure you are following me so you can see more thoughts on these cute little products and other makeup and beauty stuff. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day. Bye.